Steve Kekich here for the Sears Blue Lawn and Garden Crew. Man, am I thirsty. And come to think of it, I'm pretty hungry too. You know, I just don't do very well if I haven't had my fill of food and water. Come to think of it, your lawn doesn't do very well without these two very important things either. Fertilizer and water are essential to helping a lawn thrive. So, let's start with food. You know, fertilizer. If you've ever been down the fertilizer aisle, it can quickly get overwhelming. It may seem like there are so many choices, but a simple and basic understanding of fertilizers will help you make the right decisions. Every fertilizer has three numbers on it. These numbers in order represent the percentage of nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium in the fertilizer. These three nutrients are essential for all plant growth. The amounts of each depends on the type of plant, and in this case, the type of grass and the time of season. Many fertilizers are designed to be used for specific purposes. Starter fertilizers are great for when you're growing new grass from seed or overseeding your lawn. Spring fertilizers have the right balance of nutrients to give your lawn a fast start in the spring. Winterizer fertilizers help develop roots so that the grass does well over the dormant winter months. There are even fertilizers that mix fertilizer with weed control chemicals or insect control chemicals. Some fertilizer brands also have an entire series of products that are to be used as a set program throughout the year. So once you've figured out which fertilizer you want to use, you have a number of ways to apply the fertilizer to your lawn. Most fertilizers are the granular kind and sold in bags like this. Make sure to read the coverage specification so you buy the right amount for your size lawn. There are also liquid fertilizers that are applied with a hose end sprayer. These are typically better suited for very small lawns or small areas of grass. For the sake of our discussion, we're going to take a look at spreading granular fertilizer. There are two main types of spreaders that you can use, the drop spreader and the broadcast spreader. Drop spreaders do just that. They drop the fertilizer right under the hopper. This gives you exact control over where the fertilizer is spread, but for a large yard, a drop spreader takes a lot longer to do the job. Broadcast spreaders, on the other hand, have this spinning thrower under the hopper, which throws or broadcasts the fertilizer over a much bigger area as you push the spreader around. You have less control over where the fertilizer lands than a drop spreader, but you can fertilize large areas of lawn in far less time. Make sure you read the spreader settings on your fertilizer bag. This will tell you at what drop rate to set your spreader. This is really important because spreading too much fertilizer on your lawn can actually be harmful. Whether you use a drop spreader or a broadcast spreader, a good technique for even coverage is to walk the perimeter of the area of your lawn you're fertilizing, then go back and forth, filling in the remaining middle area, making sure you don't leave any gaps of unfertilized grass. The last thing you want is a lawn filled with green and not so green stripes. All right, now that your lawn's had a good meal, I mean fertilizing, let's help it to quench its thirst with a good watering. Regular watering of your lawn is essential to your success. No matter what you do to your lawn, if it doesn't get the water it needs, you'll never achieve the great results you want. A good rule of thumb is that your lawn should get 1 inch of water each week, either from rain or watering. A rain gauge is a great way to keep track of how much water your lawn is getting. Also, the best time to water your lawn is in the morning. That's when it's still relatively cool out and the water has the best chance of getting to the grass roots. During the midday sun, the water has a much better chance of evaporating before it can do any good and even getting to the grass roots. Also, watering at night is not a good idea because the excess moisture can promote fungus and disease. To water your lawn, you're going to need two things, a hose and a sprinkler. There are many different types of sprinklers. Oscillating sprinklers cover a large rectangular area. They're great for large, open, rectangular areas of your lawn. But if you have a lot of trees, they're not so good since the spray pattern will be obstructed. Rotary sprinklers, on the other hand, don't cover as much area, but they spray low to the ground over a circular area. These are good for smaller areas and can be accurately set to only distribute the water over a certain slice of the pie, so to speak. Other sprinklers include stationary sprinklers as well as traveling sprinklers, which are kind of like little watering locomotives that move around your yard as they water. All of these sprinklers have one thing in common. They need a hose to operate. So go measure your yard and determine, well, how much hose you're going to need. Hoses come in different lengths, and you don't want to bring one home that's too short for the job. Another cool thing you may consider purchasing is a watering timer. These nifty little devices can be set to turn the water on and off to your sprinkler for a set amount of time. That way you don't have to worry about overwatering your lawn if you go inside and forget that you left the sprinkler on. So that's pretty much it for fertilizing and watering. As for me, I'm gonna go fix myself a nice sandwich, pour myself a cool drink. Thanks again for watching, and don't forget to follow me on Twitter. Just go to twitter.com/BlueLGCrew for some great deals and more tips to a better yard. See you next time.